Just outside her show we stay. Well, all it's called. Since 1992, I think my first tour ever was with Red House Painters. We opened for the Pale Saints. I think that was in the spring of spring or summer of 1992. We did a lot of tours since then throughout the 90s and into the early 2000s. But a lot of the tours I've done on my own. I guess with the exception of some tours I've done with Phil, who played guitar with Red House Painters. I've also done maybe, you know, half a dozen tours with my band Sun Kill Moon. I've been playing guitar since before I can remember, since I was a little kid. And I'm just in a place right now that I'm playing guitar more than I ever have. The nylon string guitar is brought somehow a lot of inspiration to me that's just been kind of lacking, is being a steel string guitarist, playing 12 string guitar, steel string, electric guitar. I've kind of worn it out and it's kind of gotten old, so it's almost like I'm playing a brand new instrument.
Touching, as she gets more and more. The oldest yard cat sings her mournful bellowing from branches in a tree. The stillest oceans ring with them. And here in the half moon.
I'm not drunk. I'm just tired. I'm jet lagged.
The Scandinavian glow, I felt you like a flame, kindling my cold bone. Tonight you are my muse, as I build it and I strum. Try not to drown in the helicopter arm.
Which one's hot water for tea?
Water. Water. No water.
No water.
No water.
Alright.
No.
No water. Alright, thanks.
Up through the ashes you rose, leaving her forever paler than before. Our love for goodness enclosed with an ever burning red volcanic glow. From your honest eyes I stole, and I've forsaken you, and I amount to nothing. Still up this river's a road, following along the fishing flow forever. Thank you.
Stuck. Thank you.
I don't know. We got a bunch of shit.
Lars just called you again?
Just shut. I'm like, dude, I'm in the fucking bathroom. What do you fucking want? You know? And I don't know what it is, but he just... he likes talking to me. I swear, wherever we go, it's like, fuck, man. Find somebody else to talk to, man. Just fucking call them up. Like, I'm trying to take a fucking bath, man. It's like, I don't know, but... it's funny as fuck. I'm just like sitting there... in my fucking room. I'm taking a fucking bath. Knock, knock, knock. It's okay. What do you want? It's like, dude. I met this girl in the fucking lobby. Like, fucking go talk to her. Why are you knocking on my door? Fucking tell me about it. Like. Thank you.
sentar aquí. Marc va a subir arriba con Olga, con la traductora, y vamos a probar las luces en cuanto él haga una entrevista, ¿vale?
Okay.
Marc, do you want to make lights now? Because
yeah,
he's
let's
ready.
Do it now.
Vale, Luis, lo hacemos ahora mejor.
Vale, yo estoy en yo.
¿Vete arriba con Olga? Olga, ¿te subes tú con Agus arriba al tema de las luces?
First question is about inspiration for Admiral Fred Promises, the album. What inspired you?
Well, it started probably maybe 3 or 4 years ago. I was on tour in New Zealand. And I had some days off and I went to a record store and I picked up like a 5 CD set, a Segovia record. Just a compilation of all these recordings of his. And so I picked that up and I brought it home. And, you know, was listening to that a lot. And I think that picking up a documentary of Segovia, other classical guitarist, Julian Bream, Anna Vidovich is another one. I think listening to them, it made me feel like it was time for me to raise the bar a little bit on my playing, because when I was younger, I studied classical guitar for a little bit, but I sort of abandoned it when I got into songwriting. So I think I sort of rediscovered that style a little bit, and just, you know, for the last 3 or 4 years, I've been just really focused on the nylon string guitar.
Heaven's church.
Can I bring that direct box closer?
No.
I'll wait till he gets back.
They floated downstream like swans in the sun, surrounded by friends and loved ones. We watched on the smiles beaming so bright, the river behind them, the passing daylight. I knew her back from when she was young. Those days poured out faster than rounds from a gun, scattered like shells and lost to the sea. I have all these memories I don't know what for. I have them and I can't help it. Some overflow and spill out like waves. Some harbor all of my days. I burn like oil, you grew like a flower. I was not yours and you were not mine. Our true love finds us when it's time. We drove back downtown, wasted and spent. happy for and happy for him. The old times and the new to one car. I lay down in bed in love with the night, with my new love beside me, radiant light. I faded. Ashes you roam, leaving her forever purer than before. Still up these rivers will roam, following along the fishing flow forever. Ocean beneath me is loneliness. The cities all alone, repeating and repeating. The haunted rustling of leaves, screeching across the porch, raindrops plug the window. Thank you. their applause leaves me dead and hollow.
Just saying that, you know, it's so hard to describe to people how jet lagged and out of it you can be after travel.
Yeah, I mean, that's the thing. It's like, it's a really, it happens to me a lot when I'm in Europe or when I get to England. Say, I fly to England, and what usually happens is you get all the way over to Europe, and you got your 11-hour flight, and then maybe your other connecting flight. And by the time you get there, it's kind of like some strange hour, like 7 in the morning or 8 o'clock in the morning. You go to your hotel and you check in. They're like, we're sorry, but your room's not going to be ready until this afternoon. So you're just kind of, you're so delirious and you're so out of it. And you're on this time difference. And so what do? You kind of sit in the lobby or you kind of go walk around the streets. But, you know, when you're in places like that you're not used to, like a place like Portugal or a place like Spain or a place like London, you know, the cars drive on different sides of the streets, or sometimes the streets are like in Spain, they're very narrow. And so the cars drive very fast and very close to the curb, and so there's been countless moments. I was in Holland once, and I was just, you know, walking across the street, but this train kind of just came out of nowhere, and I just came within inches of getting run over. On this tour, my tour manager, just, you know, we were in Bologna, we were walking, he was about 3 or 4 feet ahead of me. I was so fucking tired, and I just, all of a sudden, I just saw this train coming towards him, you know, and he was looking to the right, and the train was coming from his left, and I was just like, hey, you know, I should have grabbed him, but I was so fucking delirious, because I just been, you know, I just flew in from San Francisco, and I was sitting around some airport in Frankfurt, and then like got to Bologna, and he wanted to go into town and like get something to eat. I was just like, are you sure, man? I am so fucking tired. But yeah, I mean, literally that the train just like went by, and just like he was just within an inch. I mean, he just like probably missed his nose by like an inch, but it's just, yeah, it's just kind of one of these things that happens when you're out there, you know. On this side?
In this side.
Okay.
Do you think there's anything behind everything being black and white in Spain?
I don't know what it is, but I'll tell you, the venue that I played in Tenerife was like, everything was white. We asked the promoter today about the woman that's traveling with us. We asked her about her house, and she showed us pictures inside, and her walls are all white, and white marble floors. Obviously, everything in here is white. I almost killed myself today in the bathroom on the slipping on the marble floor in there today. I got in here and took a bath. Yeah, this is a typical bathroom, Spanish hotel, all the white tile. This is where I almost slipped and broke my neck earlier when I was getting in the bath. There's always one of these things which I probably accidentally pee in the middle of the night. I don't know, I never use these, but yeah, this is kind of the typical marble, cold, hard Spanish bathroom.
Shower me in her warm kisses.
She rises low of the sky. My fallen lover died so young. A last goodbye I needed to give you, to take the loss from your fading eyes. Fallen star on lost long hours. My fallen sister died so young. The last goodbye I needed to give you, to take the loss from your faded eyes. Close these sweet and long grave curtains. Dizzy spiraling heights. How could I walk these old and lost again? How could I leave this room tomorrow? She comes by every morning, brings back pink and pale blue orchids. She comes by every afternoon. Piano music weeps quietly as May melts into June. She comes by every evening, lays down beside me softly breathing. Thank you.
Peter Scrams.
Did it, yeah.
Peter Scrams.
Best was that Peter Scrams got 24 over. Jeg skal lige se.
Do you know where it's at?
No.
Oh.
Jeg kender det ikke.
Peter Scrams.
Okay, see that.
Oh, you got it?
Eaten.
Okay, cool.
Gator scrams. Okay. You know where it's at, right? Gator scrams.
Find it?
Gator scrams.
Gator scrams got 148 deep 4 8 4.
What do you think, man? I'm thinking another cab.
No, you got it now.
You sure?
Do you think?
I don't know.
Oh, for fender.
Man, this is like...
Yeah, we're just gonna take another cab.
Yeah, we're in a hurry, man. We're in kind of a hurry.
Thank you. It's fun to get dirty when it's this easy to get clean. That's fingers, gloss, stain stain powder, and color booster works better than detergent alone and removing the toughest stains.
What do you like about touring the States versus overseas?
It's just really, really two completely different things. There's things sometimes that I like about being overseas, and there's things that I absolutely hate about it. I think the nice thing that I like about touring America is that my closest friends and the people who I love the most in my life, like my family or my girlfriend, my friends, like my closest friends are here in America. And I do have friends in Europe, but I don't have any real deep friendships with anyone that lives overseas. And I think that I'm just at an age in my life where I'm 44 years old, my parents are older. And I think whenever I travel and I know that I'm going abroad, like I'm flying, last year I was in Singapore and Taiwan, and you know, sometimes I go to Australia or I go to Europe, and I get a real sense of doom, you know, to be honest. I feel a little nervous when I go out of town that something bad's gonna happen. As an example, last year I played the Union Chapel in London, and 4 hours after I got off the stage, I got a call in my hotel that, you know, my cat had stopped walking. And I was totally worried that my cat was going to die when I was out of town. You know, I made some arrangements, and luckily I got back home the night before my cat died. But, so, you know, that was really hard for me. I had that cat for 16 years. I like touring in America because I feel close. I feel like whatever happens, like right now we're in New York, if there's any emergency in Ohio, I can be there tonight. Anything back in San Francisco, I can be there.
Last days.
carrier, my angel. Oh, 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 oh. Children gather round the bed, she rests, opal and gold. Flashes bring it up, my open eyes to lightning storm. A touch of mist felt soft, felt warm on my face. Grave ache dreams a million miles ago. You seem a star that I just
John Soundman, please don't change anything because of what he said. I can hear you very clearly. You don't have a microphone, so I'm sure you can hear me. Teaching Spanish at high school. He said you're going by joy. You cut your hair like a boy. And you don't talk with your old friends. I found a picture from before. Sitting on my lap like everything's all right. I've walked around with you on my mind. The way things were at the time. You know I've changed so much since then. I thought on things that we'd said. What if we'd had the kid? I guess he'd be 16. I found a picture from before our fight. We're in natural light. And you're sitting on my lap like everything's alright. River If the cascade in soft lines outgrown for us in the worst time, outgrown for us in the worst time, outgrown for us in the worst
things like this. Man, dude. There's a, when you go home, there's a word you should Google. Girlfriend. And that's what you want to ask me?
I asked you what your favorite Modest Mouse song was in 2006.
Dude, you are such a geek.
A city drowning God's black tear. I cannot bear to see you. She lay under the midnight moon. Huh? until the magic morning hour. Like poison, it succumbs her. Her baby skin, her old black dress. Constricts and chokes like ruthless vines, till sleep she overtakes her. Lit by candlelight and chandelier, and from her headboard perched so high, a million dreams have passed her. Don't cry, my love, don't cry no more. It overwhelms my breaking heart. A minor swell of violence I can't bear.